is working on a technology which integrates Touch ID under the phone's display. Patently, Apple uncovered a patent application number filed by Apple with the U.S. Patent and Trademark Office in January. The patent in question was filed by Dave Sedlick, no household name, but an Apple engineer who joined the firm back in 2012, notably from Authentech, the firm Apple bought for its Touch ID technology. Ahead of Apple's September announcement, and the inevitable September/early October iPhone 11 release date, new details have emerged around Apple's new iPhone thanks to a report from TrendForce. iPhone 11 design. You can still expect it to have an overly large notch, a near bezel-less display, and a very similar camera setup on the front and rear with Face ID capabilities. This means that either the iPhone 11 will be the last iPhone to use Lightning or the first to use USB Type-C. Universal charging solutions would be incredibly welcome, but we just can't see Apple moving that way anytime soon. The news comes from developers crawling through the iOS 12 beta files, finding references to a second SIM tray. Apple has a habit of giving developers clues to new hardware features as part of its iOS betas, well before they're formally announced, so we're holding out hope for dual SIM on the iPhone 11. It's also believed that both the iPhone 11 and iPhone 9 will come in a set of snazzy new liveries. iPhone 11 camera. Rumors suggest the iPhone 11 could come with a triple camera array like the Huawei P20 Pro. The news comes from Taiwan's Economic Daily News, suggesting that one comes with a 12-megapixel sensor that could also feature a 3x optical zoom. I could be everywhere. Comparing this with the P20 Pro, it seems that each of the iPhone 11's sensors could be smaller than Huawei's 40-megapixel, 20-megapixel, and 8-megapixel triple array. I could be everywhere. It's possible that it could also come to the iPhone 11 in 2018 if Apple opts to create another high-end device like the iPhone X.